After about 6 months, the engineers' pressure seemed to back off somewhat. I was permanently assigned 3 engineers to work with. No more a different engineer every couple of hours. I don't know if these guys volunteered or what, but they were sure the best. Which included my best buddy, Bill Neff. He was probably 15 years older than I, but we blazed some trails together. We developed an auto-edit technique between 2 tape decks, much the way they edited video on TV. So good did it work that the engineering department built us an official Editech console for editing that was the interface between 2 Ampex stereo reel-to-reel machines. It was 10 times faster than splice editing by hand and just as precise. I once went into A Control, which was my usual studio, at a time different from my normal schedule, and was pleased to see the tech union foreman using our Editech machine on a production he was working on. Right does win out sometimes. You just have to believe in yourself and be persistent. Just ask Louis.
...1933, and the sound was almost already legend. The blues, already classic. Whether singing or playing, no one has ever been quite like Daniel Louis Armstrong. A leader, a giant, whatever term, no one can question the stature of his contribution. Musician, showman, the wide smile, the white handkerchief, and the wide open sound of his trumpet, all combined to be a part of the Louis Armstrong story. The story mainly consists of music, most housed here in the WHS library. But a little life history anyway, just enough to give us a beginning. The field given Louis Armstrong music got a festive star-spangled start. On July 4th, 1900 in New Orleans, a sparkling, sensuous city that Louis is as responsible as any for making a jazz cradle. It's too bad that history wasn't able to record the first cry of that magnificently gravelly hoarse voice. It had to be a source of unique wonder. Could this voice have ever been a voice soprano?
Come on, people now, smile on your brother. Everybody get together, try to love one another right now. Now love is but a song we sing, and fear's the way we die. You can make the mountains ring or make the angels cry. Though the bird is on the wing and you may not know why. Come on, people now, smile on your brother.
We somehow think that Satchmo Mouth must always have had that gully low voice. And yet, in 1922, he was running around town singing tenor, believe it or not, with a Perdido Street Quartet.
I can't give you anything but love. Baby, that's the only thing I'm plenty of. Baby, dream my wild, scheme my wild, baby. You should do that. My love, my love, my love.
In 1954, this developing voice won the Downbeat Critics Poll as Singer of the Year, but hardly as a tenor. Trying to trace Louis's music would be like writing a 5-page gang of memories full of great jazz names. King Oliver, Kid Ory, Fletcher Henderson. Until he was out in front of his own band and out in front all over the United States and Europe. Talent, magic, maybe alchemy. How could that voice wrap itself around a love song? Impossible. But it happened.
Hold me close and hold me fast. The magic spell you cast. This is love you unrolls. When you kiss me, heaven sighs. And though I close my eyes, I see love unrolls. Love unrolls.
And how many cliches have been written and spoken about how his heart was in his horn? He squeezed, growled, wailed, bled, sweat, and made love through his horn. Absolutely unique. And no tribute of words can ever measure to the music. But at no time in recent years did everything work so well as when Satchmo put it together and built a modern monument to music. A song that so belonged to Louis that the movie couldn't even be made without its being a part.
Hello, Dolly. This is Louis. Dolly, it's so nice to have you back where you belong. You looking swell, Dolly. I can't tell, Dolly. You still blowing, you still growing, you still going strong. Dolly, never go away again.
That's Louie doing both his things, laying on the horn and singing. And Pops or Satch or Dippermouth always got his kick singing and spread that joy to anyone who was fortunate enough to hear. The old years, improvisations, and magic just flowed on and on.
Blue skies up above, everyone in love. Off the lazy river, how happy we will be. Mama, mama. Oh, up the lazy river, up the lazy river. Every day they live at Monday, Hardy. And the lady be there, my long night. By the door, you did, but then, oh, be there, you did that in the day. My hair is good. Oh, Martina Pérez, ya brigada, over, ya ven, y then when no now, a ver, a ver, a ver, a ver, now don't forget our Monday day. Oh, little baby, don't be late. I said don't forget our Monday day at the same little place about 8:30. Oh, my, how I miss your tender kiss. And the one doable things that you papa dance and ba da 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 di wine. I don't stay out late, don't get a go. I'm about 8 and be in the radio. I take it from me, young.
That's Louie. And this is Louie from his last album.
Oh, the easy part's over now. Yes. We've come to the end. The easy part's over now. And the hard part begins.
But that's kind of schmaltzy, and Satch, of all people, would like to let the legacy be one of joy and smiles, even if it is the blues.
Mason Street Blues, that vibe.
Some of the music here from the WHAS library dates back into the 1920s. It spans decades, depressions, recessions, periods of peace and madness of war. Always with Louis, Louie, or Pops. It was a wondrous thing.
I see trees of green, red roses too. I see them blue for me and you. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. Yes, I think to myself, what a wonderful world.
Thank you, Louis.